In this video, we will look at how to move and place objects in our Substance 3D Stager scene. When you place objects in 3D, they are positioned just like they are in the real world. As you place them, they are given a three-way coordinate. This means they will have values for horizontal, vertical, and depth positioning. We call it the X, Y, and Z coordinates. Each stager file contains one 3D world, also known as a scene. You can view your 3D world through a viewport in the center of your screen. You can view all of the objects in your scene by looking at the scene panel. You select objects by clicking on them in the scene panel or in the 3D viewport. Stager, by default, has the select tool active. You can find other tools in this panel on the left. The shortcut for the Select tool is V. You can also view each tool's options by right-clicking or performing a long left click on the icon. This will bring up a pop-up menu beside it, where you can adjust how the tool performs. When you select an object, a gizmo will appear at the original pivot position of the object. The pivot position can be changed in the object's transform settings in the Properties panel on the right. Use the pivot handle found in the center of the gizmo to move the object around the scene, snapping it to any surfaces. Using it while holding down Control or Command will translate the object around the scene while locked to your current camera view's axis. When you click on the object itself and drag it, it will move the object parallel to the ground plane. Stager automatically has snapping enabled, which creates handy light blue guides to make object placement easier. To switch this off, click the magnet icon or use the shortcut X. You can also adjust how the snapping tool performs using the drop-down menu to the right of it. The coloured handles let you move, scale, and rotate the object around the pivot on the X, Y, or Z axis. Use the arrow shapes to move the object along each axis, and use the circular shapes to rotate the object around the pivot point. Use the square shapes to scale the object. Hold down Shift when rotating to snap to 5-degree increments. Hold down Shift when scaling to scale uniformly across all three axes. Sometimes you may want to move an object that's already been rotated. The gizmo is now facing a different way, so moving along a singular axis will be difficult. You can jump between object and world transform spaces by using the drop-down in the selection tool settings, or by using the shortcut T to swap between them. By swapping to world transform space, you can then move the rotated object along your desired axes. You can select multiple objects by holding down Shift as you select them. Some objects consist of multiple geometries grouped together. These show up in the scene panel as a folder. You can click the little arrow to the left of the folder to expand it and select each component individually. You can also do this in the viewport by holding down the Control or Command key and clicking the specific geometry you want to select. One of Stager's many cool features is its collision-based transformation. This changes the behavior of the transform tools and allows objects to interact naturally with each other on contact. First, enable the global collision option found in the top left of the viewport, or use the shortcut C. This toggles the feature on. You can then enable collision individually on each object that you want to use the collision-based transform on. You will then be able to move objects around, having them interact with the ground and with other objects, provided they have collision enabled. Only objects that have collision enabled will interact with each other. We hope this has been helpful in getting you started with moving objects in Substance 3D Stager. We can't wait to see what you make.